Broadcasting from the PLA Situation Room in Roy, New Mexico, you're listening to The Snowplow Show.
Now it's time.
On Prank Call Nation.
Cactus.
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 I am playing games.
Cactus.
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 Am I supposed to be doing this?
Cactus.
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 Cactus, this cocksucker.
Cactus.
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 You've got to be crapping on my balls.
Cactus.
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 It's going to be a fuck job to edit.
Cactus.
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 Calling me a hobo.
Cactus.
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 Roy, the retarded boy.
Cactus.
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 How about if I come down and punch your head off?
Cactus.
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 You blowing smoke up my ass.
Cactus.
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 You think a tracer can stop me?
Hey everyone, it's Roy. Welcome to the Saturday edition of the Snowplow Show. Today is August 8th, 2015, and today's show is sponsored by Rhapsody Man 2000. Thanks, Rhapsody Man 2000. So, phonelosers.org/phonelosers.com is still all fucked up, but I'm definitely going to work on it this weekend. Right now, it's Saturday morning, and that's pretty much my plan for the weekend, is to just get the website all working again, because I haven't had time this past week to fix things. So expect broken things to be fixed very soon, and the broken archive should be fixed at some point, hopefully this weekend, at least this year of the archives. And definitely the secret shows. The secret shows, I'm pretty sure those are still broken right now. So you new people that have signed up to listen to the secret shows, it sucks to be you, because you can't, because the links are all broken. And it's not my fault, it's my host. My host, like two different hosts have told me now, I can't store all of my sound files on my hosting account. I don't know why, but they just seem to have a problem with 35 gigs of MP3 files on their servers. And I keep trying different hosts, you know, for sound files, and each one just doesn't work out for some reason. There's always some kind of a shortcoming with each one. But I have another plan this weekend, another thing to try, and I think this time it's going to work. So, yay! This past week was PLAcon, which was a success, I think. Only one person showed up, and it was Olga. And if you follow me on Facebook or Twitter, you probably saw some of the pictures from the con where we signed each other's PLA yearbooks and we hung out in a video arcade playing DDR for just hours and hours and hours. And at some point we were walking down the street and Olga tells me that her girlfriend really loves the hang up the phone calls and really wants me to do more of those. And I'm just like, okay, let's do some right now. So I pulled out my cell phone and my digital recorder. And the quality, I'm going to play you guys a phone call right now that me and Olga did. And the quality, the quality is okay, but there's a lot of background street noises, you know, because we're walking down the street. I mean, we're sitting on a curb doing this stuff while cars are driving by. But on the second try, here is the lady we reached as we try to do a hang up the phone call.
Here, I'm just going to... Wait, can I just call local?
Yeah.
I'll prank local, because that's always a good idea.
Yeah.
And I won't block my number either. All right, so...
Why would you do that?
I don't usually call from my cell phone. It's a horrible idea.
Yeah.
Okay. Hello?
Hello? Yes, who's calling?
Oh, just hang up the phone, okay?
What?
Hang up the phone.
Well, you called me.
I know, and I'm telling you to hang up the phone. Just do it. Don't worry about why. Just do it.
Oh, well, is this the wrong number?
No, it's not a wrong number. I know who you are.
I'm who saying, are you?
Hang up the phone.
Do
I'm
it.
Not.
Hang up the phone.
Do it.
I'm not doing it.
You better.
Why?
You hang up the phone or I'm calling 911.
For what reason?
This is Brad and this is my friend Olga.
Yeah, hang up the phone.
Brad and Olga?
You know who it is, just hang up.
Oh, I know where you live too.
Good. Hang
okay.
it up. Hang
so
up the fucking
me.
Phone,
Why
lady.
Why hang up? Why don't you hang up?
No, you hang up.
No, you do it first.
You better hang up the fucking phone.
Yeah, do it. Do it.
You better hang up the phone.
I'm not hanging up, shit.
So then, I guess we're just gonna have to hang out.
I guess so.
I guess so.
Whatever.
Whatever.
So hang up.
Yeah.
Hang up.
No, you hang up.
You hang up first.
I'm tracing this call.
Oh, I already traced your call.
No, I've already traced yours.
Well, so what?
The police are on their way.
Oh, great. Because, you know what? My son's a police officer. So.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
My dad's a police officer.
And I have a nephew who's a judge.
My dad can beat up your son.
I'm the winner.
Just hang up the fucking phone, lady.
Please don't call that name, my phone, Matt. My phone doesn't deserve that.
Okay, I'm sorry, but just hang up the phone.
You hang up.
You.
No, you.
You called me.
It doesn't matter. Just hang up.
No, you hang up.
I called you, so I'm in charge, and I'm telling you, hang up.
Well, you know what? No one's in charge of me, honey.
What do we do? They won't hang up.
We just wait. Wait.
She'll hang up eventually.
Yep.
No, I won't. I'm just going to lay the phone down and play the radio.
Oh, come on. Come on, just hang up.
Please.
We have shit to do. We got to go.
Save your life. The life of someone you love. How? Take this order and insert it into the thread of your time. See the cop is in Georgia.
So the lady turns on her radio, and we listen to commercials and country music for, I don't know, approximately 10 to 12 minutes, I think it was. And we walk for a while, the whole way just listening to country music on my phone, loudly. You know, it's turned up as we're walking down the sidewalk, as high as my cell phone will go anyway, and we're walking to the train station. And finally we get to the train station, and I decide to just give up and hang up. So the lady wins. And here's a clip of our defeat.
Here.
Wait, what, how long did it last? Where's the time? Oh, there's no time.
It'll tell you.
Logs. Well, 3:46, so 11 minutes.
Yeah. You have to turn your recorder off? Or?
Yeah. How do you feel about our recent loss?
I'm devastated by it, but it's okay.
Sometimes you just gotta admit that you lost.
Exactly.
Move on.
Exactly.
So once again, I lost the game of hang up the phone, just like I usually do, because the people that I call are so much smarter than me. They know how to not hang up that phone, and they're not gonna hang it up. And I apparently am just never gonna win that game. So thank you, Olga and Olga's girlfriend, for inspiring that call to happen. I hope this makes that guy on YouTube that keeps bitching at me about doing more hang up the phone calls happy, because I finally did one. Now shut up about it in the YouTube comments. Anyway, yeah, PLAcon was a success. It was a lot of fun. Hopefully it'll be better next year and more people will show up to it. I don't know, maybe we'll have 4 people next year instead of just 2 of us. Incidentally, there are a lot of PLAcon lanyards and badges. If anyone wants to buy those from the PLA store at phonelosers.org/store, or is it phonelosers.com/store? I don't know. I'm confused by the website. The website is really confusing this past week or two. More confusing than usual, at least. But I think everyone, every single one of you listeners, you need a PLAcon lanyard and badge and button and all that crap. So go buy one for a mere $8. I guess I should lower that price now that the con is over, right? Yeah, I should do that. I'll do that soon. But for now, you have to pay $8. You know what I should do? I should call back the lady that that wouldn't hang up her phone and see if she can give me a reason for why she wouldn't hang up her phone. So I'm going to try that right now. I really did call from my cell phone, and I didn't even block the number. So it is here in my cell phone logs from Thursday. Yeah, here, let's give this lady a call.
Hello,
this is Brad. I think I called you on Thursday and told you not to hang up the phone.
Okay, refresh my memory, Brad.
Oh, well, I told you not to hang up the phone and you wouldn't. Or, I mean, I told you to hang up the phone and you wouldn't hang up the phone.
So, what's going on now?
Oh, well, I just want to apologize for that. I'm a psychology student at Oregon State University, and it was just a psychology experiment to see if you would hang up the phone, and you didn't.
So is that a good thing or bad?
I'm not sure. I don't know what I'm doing. But you know, I'm just a student. I haven't been doing this very long. But how come you wouldn't hang up the phone? Like, why did you want to just?
Well, because I thought that what would happen would be that you'd be calling me every 5 minutes.
Oh, I wouldn't do that. I'm not that mean.
Well, but then again, I didn't know because I've had prank callers before where you hang up on them and then they're calling you maybe every 5 minutes or what have you. So I thought, okay. This will discourage that pattern.
Oh, yeah, that's some sound logic. I can understand that. Okay. Well,
yeah.
How long?
At least I give you a nice country music station to listen to.
Yeah, I really enjoyed it. Actually, I listened for about 10 minutes as I was walking down the sidewalk, so I appreciate that.
Okay, well, hey, good luck to you and your studies.
Oh, thank you very much. Oh, can I ask one question? I have to mark it down on my paper here. How long would you say you waited until you came back to the phone to see if I was gone?
Oh, you know, we have a two-level house, and when I answered your call, I was in the second level, and I probably didn't come upstairs for about an hour.
Oh, wow, an hour.
Yeah,
okay.
And I came upstairs because I had to, I don't know, do something, and I thought, oh, the phone, that's right, the phone's off the hook.
Okay, well, you definitely won that round, so congratulations.
Oh, well, thank you.
Thank you,
Brad.
Yeah, thank you for participating, and I'm really sorry to bother you yesterday, or
that's
Thursday.
Fine. Good luck in your studies.
Thank you very much.
Mm-hmm.
Have a nice day. Bye. Well, damn it. She sounds not crazy now. I almost don't want to put this in the show because it makes her seem less crazy. But there you go. There is the reasoning for one of the hang up the phone people. She didn't hang up the phone because I might call back. And she lasted approximately 50 minutes longer than me and Olga did. So she just wins all around and we are the losers. I'm going to play a reject call from Calls of Mass Confusion. It's a short one, but this is one that GAD didn't get video of in the store, or maybe just nothing happened in the store worth grabbing video of. But this is something that happened last month. This is a business called Buckles. I have no idea what that is, and I'm too lazy to look it up right now. But here is a very short call, a reject call from Calls of Mass Confusion.
Thank you for calling Buckle. This is Tamara.
Hi, this is Kevin from the corporate office with Buckle.
Oh, hello.
Hello. I'm just calling to do the weekly customer survey. Do you have a customer in there I could speak with? And we'll just do a quick survey with them.
Sure. Just one second.
Okay, just let them know they get a coupon for some money off their purchase. And...
okay, yeah. Please hold for me real quick.
Sure.
How dedicated Kim is, right?
Hi.
Hi. Is this a customer?
Yes, I am. My name is Sherry.
Okay. I'm calling from the security department with Buckle.
Uh-huh.
And we noticed that you had stolen some merchandise and put it into your clothes, so we need you to give that back, please.
Excuse me?
We need you to give that stuff back.
What do I have that I'm giving back?
Well, you know what you put hid inside your clothes. You need to give that stuff back.
I didn't steal anything.
Oh, no. We saw it happen. We have cameras in there.
No. I did not steal anything. Hello?
Hi, ma'am. That lady, she's a shoplifter. And you need to just jump over the counter and tackle her.
Who is this?
I'm Dave from the security department with Buckle.
That's really rude.
Then why are you calling on line one if you're with the security department with Buckle?
No, I'm from the corporate office security department. We were watching through the cameras and we saw her steal things.
Why would I be so willing to talk to somebody
about that?
Can you go over there and punch her head off?
Okay, well, you have a great day, sir.
Just to show her who's boss.
Bye.
No, ma'am.
Thanks for calling the Lakes Buckle. This is Lexi.
Hey, Lexi. This is Roy from the corporate office. I'm just calling to do the weekly customer survey. Do you have a customer?
Yes, you have a great day. I'm sorry. Bye.
No, for real this time. And that's it. We gave those employees probably the most exciting work day they've ever had, even though nothing really happened. Giad and I, we're not doing calls this week, you know, video prank calls, but we are going to do some more next week. And hopefully we'll use some of your ideas that you guys submitted to us these past few days. You guys have been really great about sending ideas in the comments on YouTube and the comments on phonelosers.com. And I've gotten a few through email and everything. So thanks, everyone, for sending ideas. I can't remember offhand what any of the ideas are, but I'm sure we'll be able to use something. Also, regarding Calls of Mass Confusion, I'm going to talk to GAD and see if he wants to... maybe we can put up one of our good video pranks on the YouTube page for Calls of Mass Confusion. Because so far, we put up mostly just reject material. You know, just stuff that we're probably not going to use. And I think it's about time we put up something good. So I'm going to talk to GAD about that. And maybe that'll happen soon. I know we've talked about it before, but we never ended up doing it for some reason. Hey, you know what we haven't done enough of on shows recently? We haven't called hotel customers from this giant list that Matt sent me. You know, customers who stayed in a hotel recently and somehow Matt knows about it and has their home phone numbers and their addresses and notes about their rooms. So let's do a little bit of that. Maybe I'll just do nothing but that for the rest of the show because that's easy and I won't have to go through all the dumb requests in the request folder.
Hello.
Hello, Cheryl.
Matt's just calling.
Well, this is Dave from the... You stayed at our hotel about a month ago.
Mm-hmm.
And I was just wondering, why did you do that? Why did you do that when you left?
Excuse me?
Why did you do that? Like, how
did I do what?
You know what you did. That's really immature, and our maids had to clean it up, and it was gross.
Excuse me?
What do you mean, excuse me?
I don't even know what the hell you're talking about.
Oh, you know what I'm talking about. It was disgusting.
All right, look, have a good day. God bless you, sweetheart, because I don't play these type of games.
You're a filthy animal.
Listen, I don't have time to play games with whoever you are calling my phone. Listen, I don't have time for that, okay?
I'm going to charge you a $20 cleanup fee for what you did.
Listen, you don't got to worry about that because they didn't even have to clean my room. I clean my room every day. So I got that verification because I got that in my phone.
Yeah, but
every day.
When you left,
thank you, sir.
You pooped.
So I don't know what you're talking about or anything to that effect because I clean my room every day. I never got maid service, only towels.
I know, but
every hotel I stay in. No one comes inside my hotel room but just to place my towels. So I ask for what you're talking about.
Hey, shut up.
If something occurred after I left,
no.
That has nothing to do with me, sweetheart.
You know you pooped in the middle of the floor and it's disgusting.
Oh God, you sound very dumb. You sound very,
at least
very
I don't
dumb.
Poop in the middle of the floor when I stay in a hotel.
Okay, well, you have a blessed day. I'll put you on call restriction. Thank you.
Oh, you better. So was that a male or a female? I mean, his name is Cheryl, but then he's calling me sweetheart and telling me to have a blessed day. By the way, I'm not doing these live on the air today because the air is in use by another prank call host. So it's just me, but I still have the list of ideas that I got from the chat room during my last two shows, and I am using that, even though the poop idea was my own.
Hello?
Hello, I'm calling for Lewis.
He's not here. Can I check a message?
Oh, well, I'm calling from the hotel. Did you stay at the hotel with them?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I don't know if it was you or if it was him, but one of you two pooped in the middle of the floor. Before you left.
We didn't stay there. When was this?
Oh, it was back, it was just a few days ago.
No, we weren't there.
Yeah, you were.
We were there at the beginning of June, we were there.
I know, but you also had a reservation. Did you cancel?
Yeah, but we didn't stay there. We canceled.
I know, but then the last time you were there, though, in June, you pooped in the middle of the floor, and that's gross.
No, we didn't.
Yeah, you did.
No, we didn't.
We did DNA testing.
Who is this I'm talking to?
We did DNA testing, and we know it was you.
What?
We did DNA testing on the poop, and we know it was you.
Who is this calling?
My name is Roy. I'm the front desk manager here at the...
I don't know what you're talking about.
Poop. You know what poop is, right?
Yeah, but I don't know what you're talking about.
I mean, did you have a dog that pooped in the middle of the floor?
No, we don't have a dog.
Okay, well, it must have been one of you two, then. He pooped in the middle of the floor. That's really gross. Grow up, ma'am.
Hello?
Hi, Rory?
Yes?
Hi, this is Roy from the hotel.
Yes?
And you stayed with us recently, you know?
Yes?
And I don't know which one of you guys did it, but somebody, before you guys left, you pooped in the middle of the floor, and that's kind of gross. What?
No way.
Oh, yeah. No, somebody did. Somebody, before you left that room, you pooped, and the maid had to clean it up. Right in the middle of the floor.
No.
Yes, you...
Absolutely not.
Oh, yes, you did.
What days are you talking about?
You were here, in the middle of July. You were here on the 17th?
Yeah.
Did one of your kids poop in the floor?
No, I have a baby that's in diapers, but
it looked like an adult poop.
No, absolutely not.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was you, and that's why you're denying it. And I just want to let you know, we're not going to charge you a cleaning fee or anything, but I just want to let you know you're a disgusting human being. You shouldn't do things like that. And please don't do it again.
Well, it just didn't happen.
It did so. I mean, who else would it be? Do you think the maid pooped in the floor?
I have no idea.
I don't think our maid would poop in the floor.
I've stayed at your hotel dozens of times.
And you don't usually poop in the floor, so why'd you poop in the floor this time?
That's what... that sounds really, really, you know, off the wall.
I know. Why would you do that? Just please don't do it again, okay?
I don't understand. What room number was it?
Oh, I don't even know offhand. Look, I'm telling you.
I'm curious about it because you have a few rooms that have that pets come in, and we didn't have any pets.
Sir, could you shut that kid the fuck up? We're trying to talk.
Excuse me?
Could you shut that kid the fuck up? We're trying to talk.
What is your name?
This is Roy.
Okay, I'm going to call back the hotel.
Okay, well, can you just shut him the fuck up before you call back?
I think you really ought to watch the language that you're using towards me right now.
Oh, no, it's not toward you. It's toward your kid more. I was just hoping you could...
Doesn't make any difference. That kind of language is uncalled for speaking to anybody.
Oh, but it's so irritating just listening to that kid. Ugh. You know, he hung up on me. Was that one even funny? I don't think that one was funny. I'm going to stop saying that people pooped in the floor. That's starting to get old.
Hello?
Hello, is Edward there?
Who's calling, please?
Well, this is Roy from the hotel.
Ed's not here right now, but I can take the call.
Oh, okay. Well, I just needed to let him know that there's a stench coming from his room, and we're going to have to go in there and see what it is.
What?
You know, the hotel that he's currently staying in, there's a stench coming from his room. And we're going to have to go in there and just check it out, make sure everything's okay.
Is this a joke?
No, of course not. Why would it be a joke?
Why would you be calling me about Ed and we're not even staying at the...
Oh, yeah, you are. You checked in on July 3rd. And you're still here. Yeah, there's a stench coming from your room. Room 127.
What are you talking about? We're not in any hotel.
You didn't check in on July 3rd?
On July 3rd? Yeah.
Okay, yeah, that's you're the person. Yeah, you're staying in our hotel. Oh, I guess Edward's staying in our hotel. Your name's not on here.
No, he's not. We're not there.
Well, you've been paying for the past month.
No, you have the wrong party.
No, there's. You've been here since July 3rd, and you're still here.
You're gonna tell me where we are?
Well, you're paying for the hotel room, so it'd be really stupid if you're not here.
How have we been paying for the hotel room?
With money. Durr. Look, all I'm saying is I just need to let you know. I want to give you a heads up. We're going to come in the room and check it out.
But you're not talking to the right party.
It says Edward right here, room 127. And he never...
We are not there.
But you never checked out, so you're still here.
What do you mean we never checked out?
You guys never checked out, so you're still paying for the room. It's been empty all month.
Of course we checked out.
No, you didn't. Nobody checked out. Maybe you forgot to check out. No, you've been paying for this room for a month now.
No, we haven't.
Oh, yes, you have. Are you telling me this room's been empty all month and you've been paying for it?
Are you going to tell me? I know we checked out. We gave the key back. I got the paper. What do you mean we didn't check out?
Oh, we don't have any record of you checking out. No, you guys are still listed as being in the room.
No, we're not.
Yeah, you're still in there. I mean, it's just...
No, there's something wrong. This is impossible.
How is it impossible?
We're not there.
You forgot...
What do you mean how it's impossible? We didn't forget anything. We checked out.
No, you forgot to check out this time. Oh, that was so dumb.
No, we didn't forget to check out.
That was so dumb of you. How can you forget to check out?
Excuse me?
I'm just saying that was a really dumb thing to do. You got to check out when you leave a hotel or you're just going to be still in
there.
Are
you playing around with me?
Of course not. No, this is ridiculous because, you know, we're fully booked and we've had to turn people away and you're saying that room's been empty.
How can you not know what's going on in your hotel?
Well, we know what's going on. You forgot to check out, so we thought the people were still in there. You know, we thought you guys were still in
there. This is a joke. This is a real joke.
Oh, no,
you're going to tell me that for over a month, you're telling me that we're still there when we checked out?
No, you didn't check out. You forgot to check out, ma'am. Just admit that.
No, we didn't forget to check out.
Just admit that you made a mistake.
There's no mistake to admit.
Well, then why am I making this call? It's because you didn't check out.
Oh, this is insane.
Now, you're the one that's insane for getting to check out like this. And yeah, you've been paying for this room every night. You're going to have a huge bill when you finally check out. You need to come here immediately and check out.
We are not there.
I know. You need to come here and check out if you're not here. Otherwise, you're going to keep paying for this room. Don't be dumb, ma'am. Don't be dumb.
Excuse me? How are you talking to me like this?
Because you're the one with the attitude. You started it. So I think you're being...
No, you called me and telling me after a month that I'm still living in your hotel room?
Well, you don't live here. You're just staying here for a month. You can't live in a hotel.
I want to speak to a supervisor.
Oh, no, the supervisor is not even here. He's on lunch right now.
How convenient for you.
Yeah. That's right. Listen, you stupid hoe, you just need to come here and check out, all right? And then everything will be fine.
How dare you talk to me this way?
Well, how dare you this inconvenience our hotel with this stupidity?
What is your name?
My name is Roy.
I work Roy what?
No, Roy who? H-I-U.
And you have the nerve to call me a stupid hoe?
Well, you're kind of being a stupid hoe, in all fairness. I mean...
In all fairness, this is how you talk to people?
You just need to come to the front desk and check out, okay? And everything will be fine. And we are going to...
I'm calling the police.
We are going to have to go in your room and see what this is.
I'm going to call the police.
For what?
Because you have some nerve calling me about the room that I am not in.
Well, how is that the police's problem?
I'm calling the police because you're harassing me.
This is not harassment. It's a single phone call, and it's regarding the business that you're doing with our hotel.
I'm calling the police.
You can call them if you want, but you're just wasting their time and making yourself look like an idiot. Like, hello, police. Okay, she's gone. So what police is she going to call? Is she going to call the one that the hotel's in, or is she going to call the police in her own state? I'm very curious about this. I almost want to call her back, but I won't, because that would be harassment.
Hey, Arby, it's Carl. That's kind of a shoe. So hopefully this comes through.
Oh, yeah.
I think I might be able to get a Cactus number for you.
Not
I'm
too
out
well
here
so
in Malibu,
far.
And I was throwing these logs, somebody's firewood, into the ocean.
You're an asshole.
Lady came out to the beach in one of the houses complaining, yelling at me. I basically told her to fuck off and she was an idiot. That just set her off even more. But yeah, I'm going to work on getting that number. Hopefully she has a number connected to her address.
Yeah, okay, that's enough of your cell phone connection. Yeah, what a horrible, horrible jerk that lady was, yelling at you for throwing her firewood in the ocean. She totally deserves a phone call.
Here, Brad. It's Corbin Guy. And
hey, two-minute voicemail guy.
This is incredibly fucking awesome. I know you hate it when people call in with ideas, so
yep.
I'm going to piss you off.
Gonna hang up on you.
Calling in with an idea. But
great.
Secondly, I know that you like less work, and this is a homework assignment for all the listeners. Okay. Less work for you, more work for your listeners. And this actually might be a pretty good idea. So, how about this?
30 seconds now of what a good idea he's about to say.
Have your listeners go to their local fast food restaurants and other stores and facilities,
mm-hmm.
pick up applications, and fill them out in the most fucked up way possible. Fill them out so there's not a chance in hell the individual can even be hired, and then have them scan the document, email it to rbcp@phonelosers.org or .com. I'm still unsure about the website.
Nobody knows anymore,
and,
not even me.
Then from there, you will have a list of businesses with fucked up resumes where you are trying to obtain work from, and you can call back to check up on the application or the status of your application or whatever, and there might possibly be some sort of wackety, you know, craziness come about from that.
There
so
could be.
How's that for an idea? A homework assignment, less work for you, more work for the listeners, and I just pissed you off by leaving a voicemail so of an idea. All right.
God damn it.
Fuck you very much. Have a pleasant afternoon.
Bye, Corbin. I like that idea. I'm up for that. If anyone wants to fill out applications at fast food places or anywhere else, really. The only problem I see is, do businesses really even have paper applications anymore? I thought when you asked for an application, they're just like, go online. It's 2015, stupid. But maybe they still do paper applications too. I don't know. If anyone would like to do that, though, you can do the application thing and then email it to me at rbcp@phonelosers.org. And I have no idea what I would say to the people who I call, but I'm sure we'll think of something, or maybe you can think of something for me. I don't like to think.
Hey, Roy, you don't know me, but I'm from California, and I'm a very huge fan, and please continue making these wonderful shows, and I'm about to donate on your channel.
Yay.
And yeah, Cactus Cactus.
Actually, I do know you, but we won't get into that.
Hey, Brad, it's Tycoon.
Hey, Tycoon.
Hey, here's an idea. Look, I know that you don't have regular...
Great, more ideas, just what I love.
...scheduled shows, and half the time you just pre-record shit.
Yup.
But, I mean, if you go on the air, why don't you just, I don't know, tweet about it or something? There's
yeah.
your genius idea.
I used to do
That's
that.
That's what you really need to be doing. Because if you really want people to, you know, give you some ideas from the chat room, people have to know that you're on the air.
That's so much extra work, though. That's an extra step that I have to do. I'm way too lazy for that. But yeah, I used to do that all the time. I don't know why I don't do it as much anymore. I will try to do that more often whenever I go on the air.
Hey, Brad! It's DJ Greg, 103.3 The Gerber. I'm going to give you a quick call, give you a shout-out live on the air, just let you know you're doing an absolutely outstanding job.
Thanks, DJ Greg.
I am the angry Indian guy in the studio right now. Angry Indian guy.
Hello, Brad! I am just calling because you are fascist! You're such a racist!
Ah, thanks so much, Adrian, man. Well, hey, Brad, I just want to give you a shout-out live on the air, slamming, jamming, playing old jams here. I'm going to give you a quick call, give you a shout-out live on the air. Want to let you know you're doing a great job, Brad. Having a great job. You're a great job, man. All kinds of
thanks.
Great jobs. All right, well, hey, I gotta go. Gotta get back to slamming, jamming, DJ, and playing funky tunes on the radio. So I just want to again say, have a great day, Brad. All right,
bye,
PLA
DJ
for the
Greg.
Win.
You know what Spotify doesn't have enough of? That. Don't you guys just really miss hearing someone like that talk all over all your music? I know I do. I hope Spotify fixes that problem soon. Anyway, one more last voicemail, and then I promise that this hell on earth is over.
Hi, Brad.
Hi.
I am a new listener.
Okay.
And I must confess, I can't breathe. I like your show. Your voice is so soothing.
Okay.
Fuck me, mine's not. All right, hold on. God damn it, this is why people sound so stupid on your fucking show. All right. Hi, Brad. I'm
See,
a new listener.
You're one of them now. It's fine. Everything's fine.
I must confess, I like your show, and your voice is so soothing that I actually fall asleep every night listening to you. I dream of cacti up the asses of the masses. Thanks, Brad.
Nice. Thanks for calling, and thanks for the new slogan that the Snowplow Show is going to use from now on, forever. I bet you guys thought after the voicemails I was going to do more phone calls, but that was a stupid thing for you to think, because I'm not. Actually, I tried to call more of these hotel people, and I called the entire list. Nobody's answering. And I tried quite a few prank requests. None of those are working out, or they're just not answering. And it's getting kind of late, and I really need to just wrap up this show. So, no more brand new pranks today. Instead, I'm just going to cheat like I do occasionally, and I'm going to play stuff that's exactly 1 year old. Or not exactly, but approximately 1 year old, according to my YouTube channel on youtube.com/phonelosersofamerica. So, what I see from 1 year ago that I want to play, we have the Grass Killer Calls. Remember the original Grass Killer Calls, those original two? Those were really funny, but no, I think I played those recently, so I'm not going to do that. So, it looks like 1 year ago, which will be in 5 days from now, 1 year ago, would be the Tenants From Hell, Nazi Gold. Remember the Nazi Gold call? I love that one. So we're going to play that one, and it's not really long though, so I think I'm going to play two calls. Two old calls that are pretty funny, in my opinion. I'm going to play this other one, which was 1 year ago, a few days ago. And it's also a Tenants From Hell. It's the Lost in the Tunnels call. I mean, there's a bunch of those, but this is one in particular that I remember, and we're going to play that one. So prepare for two calls that you've already heard before, but if you're a new listener, maybe you've never heard these, and maybe this will convince you to go back and listen to the old show archives, which you can't do because my site's all broken. But, you know, go to youtube.com/phonelosersshows, and you can listen to the old shows on there since the site's all messed up. But here it is, two classic calls that hopefully you will enjoy. Momo Mamo, he says, this is the apartment complex he lives in. I went creeping through the hallways a couple days ago and got you two names and apartment numbers for you to give him, as well as some last names and apartment numbers. It's a historic building before World War II, so there are decorative swastikas and creepy Indian head carvings in the lobby. Those are some spooky-ass Indian heads carved into the ceiling. I'm pretty sure your apartment building's haunted.
Thank you for calling Del Prado.
Hi, I'm a tenant here at Del Prado in 413.
Mm-hmm. How can I help you?
And part of our wall's kind of caving in, like the ceiling's caving in, I mean.
In 413?
Yeah, it's between 413 and next door, because I've been dating the girl next door, and we, you know, we removed the wall in between our two apartments, but apparently that was a load-bearing wall. We didn't know. And so since we removed...
Okay. Let me see. I think maintenance is gone, but let me see. Let me get your phone number.
Sure. It's 708-2835.
2835, and your name?
My name is Michael Borosh.
Mike. Okay, let me get back in touch with you in a few minutes, okay?
Okay. Do you know what I should do about the cave-in and ceiling, though? Should I...
I will call you right back, okay?
Stack up a table underneath it or something?
Let me call you right back. Let me talk to my manager, and I'll call you right back, okay?
Okay. All right.
Okay. Bye-bye. Thank you for calling Del Prado.
Oh, hey, this is Michael Borosh again.
Hi, I've been trying to get in touch with you. We've been trying to get... We've knocked on your door twice because we needed to get a visual of what's going on.
Oh, I was in the bathroom.
Is it possible I can come up and take a look at it?
I was in the shower. Well, here's the thing. It's caved in even more, and now all these gold coins are falling from the area where we cut out. So, but
can I come up and take a look at it?
They're coming from kind of in the middle. So, like, do you know, do I get ownership of all the gold coins, or is it the apartment's property?
Okay. Is it possible for me to come up and take a look at it?
Well, I want to get all the gold coins out of the wall first and put them in a safe, because I don't want you stealing them. But they have, like, Nazi symbols on them.
And, where are the gold coins coming from?
They're from the ceiling, because I chopped out the entire wall in between my apartment and the girl's apartment next door. And I guess there was, like, a bunch of gold coins, doubloons, stashed up there. And they're all kind
okay.
of...
Okay,
So I've got to get all these...
Somebody from maintenance is coming to take a look at that, okay? I just called emergency maintenance, so somebody is coming to take a look at it, okay?
I'm not letting anyone in to, like, because, I mean, these are a lot of gold coins. This has to be worth millions, I would think. And I don't want maintenance stealing my gold coins.
Are these your coins?
Well, they are now, because they're in my apartment.
Okay. Give me a number where I can reach you, because the number you gave me is disconnected.
Oh, it was? Okay, well, my home phone is 773-6841.
Okay, I will get back in touch with you, okay?
So officially, though, I mean, the gold coins would be mine, right? Because they're in my apartment?
Let me give you a call right back, okay?
Or, I mean, I could share them with the girl next door, because we are seeing each other. We'll probably just split
the
coins.
Let me give you a call right back,
well,
okay,
don't,
Mr. Borosh?
Don't be a jerk about it. I'm just asking a question.
I understand what you're saying, but I need to speak to somebody to find out the answer to your question, okay?
About the gold coins?
So let me...
Let me, yes, and in reference to the wall and the ceiling being caved in. So okay. Let me call you right back, okay?
There's a water leak, too, by the way. There was a pipe in the wall. And, like, when the ceiling collapsed, it kind of...
All right, I will call you right... Let me call you right back, okay?
Well, can I call you back?
All right, thank you.
Okay.
Yes, that's fine.
Okay,
thank you.
5 minutes? 6 minutes?
Thank you for calling Depardo.
Oh, hey, it's Michael again.
Let me put you on hold for one moment, okay?
Why?
Okay.
Why?
Hold on 1 second, okay?
What,
hold on.
What? All right.
Hey, Michael. This is Joseph.
This who?
This is Joseph, the maintenance guy.
Oh, hey.
How you doing? You got some water leaking up there?
Yeah. Well, I've sort of taken care of that. I put duct tape because the pipe was kind of buckling out from the, you know, from the stress of the ceiling crushing down on top of it.
Mm-hmm. You mind if I come take a look at it?
Oh, not today. I've got to sort through all these things. There's like gold doubloons coming from the ceiling. And I've got to get the rest of them out and put them in a safe or something.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Okay. Bye. But is the other lady still on?
Thank you for calling Del Prado.
Oh, I got disconnected from the maintenance guy somehow.
Okay. But, how can I help?
Oh, I was just wondering because I was looking under the floor from where this water pipe's coming from, and there's like all these old stock certificates. From the night.
Okay, you need to let somebody into the unit so they can see what's going on, Mr. Borish.
Well, I gotta.
Okay.
I gotta.
Somebody needs to get in to take a look at the unit, okay?
Well, it's gonna. What I'm saying, it's gonna be a while because I gotta hang up these stock certificates. They got wet from the pipe.
Okay, Mr. Borish.
And I think they're worth a lot of money.
They need to get in to take a look, Mr. Borish. They need to get in to take a look at the unit to see what's going on, okay?
Maybe tomorrow because I got the pipe all. It's taken care of. I duct taped it. So there's no more leaking.
Okay, Mr. Borish, hold on one moment, okay?
All right.
Hold on.
All
right. Hold on.
All right.
Thank you for calling Del Prado.
Oh, hey, it's Michael. Oh, I got put on hold and I never heard back.
What can I do for you, Mr. Borish?
Couldn't we just wait till tomorrow for someone to come by?
Somebody will come tomorrow at 1 o'clock.
Oh, that might be too early because I got to dry out all these stock certificates.
They're coming tomorrow at 1 o'clock, Mr. Borish. That's the time they're scheduled. It's 1 o'clock tomorrow.
Well, I might not answer. I might not be around because I got to go to the safety deposit box and put all these stock certificates. There's over 800.
Okay, Mr. Borish, somebody needs to get in that unit and it's scheduled for 1 o'clock tomorrow.
But there's over 800 gold coins here, so I have to make sure I get those put away.
There are 800 gold coins, and how many stock certificates did you find?
I don't know. It's just like a giant stack of them.
Okay, Mr. Borish, I have spoken to the chief of maintenance. He set it up for 1 o'clock tomorrow. That's all I can do, okay?
Okay.
You won't let them in to check today because the maintenance guy is here. Will you let him in to just take a look at the wall and see?
Maybe tomorrow if I've got everything ready.
Okay, well then it's set up for tomorrow at 1 o'clock, okay? Somebody will be there tomorrow at 1.
I don't want the maintenance guy stealing my gold doubloons.
Somebody will be in your unit tomorrow at 1 o'clock, Mr. Borish. Okay?
Is he honest? Do you know if he's like an honest guy?
Mr. Borish.
Yes?
Tomorrow at 1 o'clock, okay?
Okay.
Thank you. Have a great day.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
This is Amy.
Hey, Amy. I'm calling from the apartment building. I rent an apartment from you guys over on Bishin Avenue.
I'm sorry, you're echoing.
I'm underneath the apartment. I'm over on Bishin Avenue, apartment 1.
Oh, I'm Bishin. You live in apartment 1?
Yes.
Okay.
The bottom apartment.
Uh-huh.
And I was pulling up all the carpet. Okay, I pulled up all the carpet in the living room and there was this door underneath. So I went down into the door. And like there's this tunnel. Can you hear me okay?
Okay. Kind of, sort of.
Okay.
I'm confused. You live in Bishin number 1. You pulled up the carpet. There was a door underneath the carpet. So you went in the door, and it's a tunnel under the building?
Yeah, well, it's more than under the building. I've gone at least 5 blocks now.
It's gone for 5 blocks?
Yes. Yes. I hope you can hear me okay. My cell phone signal isn't too strong down here.
I can hear you, yes. This is actually the leasing line. I'm going to need you to call Alyssa and let her know that.
Oh.
Because that is crazy.
Well, I mean, I just, like, I've gotten kind of lost because I've gone down several stories now. Like, I'm 3 stories below ground and about 5 blocks away, but there's lots of different tunnels.
So you're lost in there?
Yeah, I have no idea how to get back to the apartment. All I have is my cell phone light.
You need to call 911.
No, I'm not in any trouble. As far as I can tell, the air is okay down here.
So I don't understand how I can help you.
Yeah, I just wasn't sure if you could give me directions, like if you knew about the tunnel.
Sir, I've never been in the tunnel, nor was I aware that there is a tunnel, so I definitely cannot give you directions out of the tunnel because I didn't even know it existed.
Yeah, it's in the hallway. And
I'm sorry?
Huh?
Can you say that one more time?
It's in the hallway.
In the hallway?
Yeah, well, that's where the tunnel starts. And I went down into the hallway. There were stairs there originally, but they had rotted away. I had to use a rope.
What's your name?
I had to use a rope to crawl down. My name is Roger. And it was, it's like a 20-foot drop. So I'm not sure if I can get back up, actually. But anyway, like, I've gone several stories down at this point, and I'm about 5 blocks away, I would estimate.
Okay. I honestly don't have any idea how to help you. Can you hold on just a second so I can get somebody else for you?
Oh, who are you going to get?
Can you hold on just a second?
Okay.
Thanks. Sir, Alyssa's not here at this time, and I honestly don't know how to help you, and I didn't even know that there was a tunnel there. Here's my recommendation for you, to call Alyssa, and if you can't get out, to call 911.
Oh, no, I'm not. No, I can't talk to 911, not since the incident.
Why can't you call 911?
It's hard to explain. They've got it in for me, though, like, since the last time.
911 has it in for you?
I'm just saying it's not...
I'm really sorry. I don't understand. I cannot help you other than to advise you to call 911 and to do the best you can to get out of there, because if you're trapped in a hole under a building, you have got to call 911.
Well, no, I'm not trapped at all. I'm not trapped. I just have to find my way back, because right now I'm like 5 blocks away. What am I going to tell 911? Just start digging random holes in the neighborhood until you find me?
No one can come find you because I don't know where you are. And I am definitely not going running around through tunnels. What's your last name, sir? You said it's Roger?
Yeah. Hey, there's like
what's
this...
What's your last name?
Okay, like I'm in the room. I'm in the big cavernous area next to the waterfall.
There's a waterfall?
Yeah, underneath. I'm 3 stories down now. I think I might be near the lake. But there's some writing on the wall. And it says, "Ye intruders beware, crushing death and grief. Soaked in blood of the trespassing thief." Do you know what that would translate to? It's in Spanish. I don't understand Spanish.
No, sir, I don't speak Spanish. But look, I have to get off the phone because I've got things to do today, but I can't help you other than to tell you to please call 911 to get help to get out of that building.
I have things to do too.
If you are under... I'm sorry?
Well, hey, wait, could you come in my apartment and maybe set some sort of beacon down, like... Maybe just
no. I'm not going to go in your apartment and set up a beacon. I'm sorry, I just can't do that.
Well, you can
call 911 and get out.
No, listen. In my closet, there's a boombox, and all you'd have to do is lower the boombox and have it turned on really loud.
Sir, I'm not going to do that for you. Well, okay, you need to call 911. I'm not emergency services.
No, it's not an emergency. I'm just trying to find my way home. But if you just turn on the radio...
If you can't find your way home and you're lost under a building, then that absolutely is an emergency, and it is a huge liability for me to sit here on the phone with you. I'm half tempted to call 911 and send them over there.
Don't you dare. No, they're not. They'll be...
Well, if
Roger.
You keep me on the phone, sir, I'm going to call 911 and send them right over there to find you.
Why can't you just come over and put a radio down the hole?
Because I'm not going to come over there, and I'm hanging up right now. I do wish you the best of luck, and I hope you have a great time.
Well, you obviously don't wish me the best of luck if you won't even help me find the opening. So there you go. 2 classic calls from a whole year ago, more or less. And that's going to do it for today's show. I wish more new calls would have worked out, but thanks to Rhapsody Man 2000, it's all his fault that they didn't work out. Nobody would answer, or they would just hang up on me, or it just wasn't funny. So thanks a lot for that, Rhapsody Man 2000, big jerk. Thanks for listening, everyone. I'm going to continue doing PLA stuff for the rest of the day by fixing my website and hopefully fixing the archives. And it's just going to be a PLA-filled day for me here. I can't wait to spend the rest of my entire day doing this stuff. If you still have problems with the website a day or two from now, be sure to contact me, rbcp@phonelosers.org, and let me know what the problem is, and I will try to fix it if I can. But I think I'm going to take care of things today. I think things will be much better after today, which may or may not include the old show archives. But until the website works, visit us on facebook.com/phonelosers, on twitter.com/phonelosers, youtube.com/phonelosersofamerica, and support the show at patreon.com/phonelosers or phonelosers.com/cactus. Everyone who supports the show is really amazing. I really appreciate it. And you must hate me because I'm not using that money to make my site not broken all the time. But I promise it's going to happen. I'm going to work on it right now as soon as I get this show up. Thanks for listening, everyone. Goodbye.
This is the PLA radio show, coming straight out of Roy, New Mexico. So don't touch that dial and don't touch that tone. We'll call you up on your telephone. We'll call you up and pose as your phone company. Inquire about 900 numbers that cost a lot of money. And when you're frustrated and you don't know what to say, we'll inquire politely, does your wife know you're gay? Yeah, you better pick up or we'll hack your voicemail. Tell people to fuck off and go to hell. Yeah, with RBCP and the rest of the gang, calls can get crazy and downright insane. When we visit your Facebook, you'll always get 5 stars. We love your cactus entrees and your glory holes on large and well padded. Yeah, we'll give it away that it's a prank call. We don't give a fuck, not a fuck at all. Yeah, we'll give it away that it's a prank call. We don't give a fuck, not a fuck at all. We'll hack your brain, make you insane. By the time that we're through, you'll be scratching your head, what the fuck did I just do? So lock the doors, flip off the breakers, get on the floor. I've got some blue Gatorade for you to pour. I'd like to bid $5 million on the cactus. Go ahead, hang up on me, there's plenty more of us. We can mob your radio station all damn day. Who the fuck bids on the radio when we've got eBay? Yeah, we'll give it away that it's a prank call. We don't give a fuck, not a fuck at all. Yeah, we'll give it away that it's a prank call. We don't give a fuck, not a fuck at all. God help you if you answer our Craigslist ad. You're so easy to fool that it's really kinda sad. And we can't be held responsible if we make you mad. Can you believe our parents said this was just a fad? Yeah, we're crazy awesome hackers and we're very self-reliant. You ask us why we do this, we say that it's for science. So don't call the cops, don't even bother to sue. At 12 o'clock at midnight, fuck you. Every Monday brings a tear to my eye. Why did Mildred Monday have to go and die? Her sons were so beautiful and so kind. Ooh. probably should call him back just one more time. Yeah, we'll give it away that it's a prank call. We don't give a fuck, not a fuck at all. Yeah, we'll give it away that it's a prank call. We don't give a fuck, not a fuck at all. This is the PLA Radio Show, coming straight out of Roy, New Mexico. So don't touch that dial and don't touch that tone. We'll call you up on your telephone. That dial tone, though.
You're Roy and you laid down in my backyard and you got dog poop in your hair.